I certainly have concerns that when you look at what's happening, as we've discussed, on the Ethiopia-Sudan border, it's really hard to divorce that level of anxiety along the border and that level of military buildup. It's hard to divorce that from the talks that are going on the GERD right now, right? And when you add to that then a kind of third power, the Egyptians, which are not an insignificant power. They're a large, populous, wealthy, militarized power. So that really does, I think, up the ante in this conflict and in this region. And you know, we have to be very careful about how we bring the Egyptians into this. They have real concerns. The Sudanese, not unlike the Egyptians, have redefined the GERD as a national security concern. You know, they're using the same language as the Egyptians in defining what a priority this is right now. And so I think we have to take that very seriously. At the same time, you have Ethiopia, which, you know, I don't like to use the metaphor, but is sort of thrashing about almost like a wounded animal. And it is, because it is experiencing an open wound in the Tigray region right now. And I think we're all sort of struggling to understand how that is resetting the politics of Ethiopia, how that is inflaming certain nationalist sentiment. We're obviously seeing a buildup with their neighbor Sudan. And so I think we have to be very careful about how hard we push on the GERD right now. But there's no question that it needs international involvement to sort of lower the temperature. And as we've all been reminded, the rainy season is fast approaching in this region. And so whether we like it or not, there is nature's calendar, which is at play here, which is, you know, doesn't really fit our political calendar. And we're gonna have to deal with that. But the rain will start falling in the next month or so in this region, and the dam will start filling again, naturally.